Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we learned about the basics of layout in Jetpack Compose. And in this video, we will move ahead and we will learn about lists in Jetpack Compose. And while building Android applications, most of the time we have to build some kind of list. And the most common component that we were using with XML was RecyclerView. And in this video, we will see how we can replicate a RecyclerView in Jetpack Compose. So let's come back to our project. So this is the last project. We created this user card in the last video and I have made some changes. For example, I removed the border and instead of a box, I am using a card to give some elevation to my user card. So now I am using a card and I have some modifier for this card and I have this elevation. So this is this card that we are seeing here. So now in this video, we will build a list of this user card. So we will see multiple user cards vertically. So in the last video, we learned we can use column to display a list of vertically aligned items. And we can use column to build a scrollable list as well. So let's see how we can do this thing. So I will create a function. Let's say I have one more composable function that is user list. And inside this function, I will use column because I want to create a vertical list. So I will create column and to this column, I will pass a modifier. So I have modifier and I will use modifier dot vertical scroll. Now if I pass this modifier, that is vertical scroll, that means I want my column to be scrollable vertically. The same way you have a horizontal scroll function. If you want to display a list that should scroll horizontally, you can use that modifier. But you will use that modifier with row and not column. So in this case, we have a column and we have this vertical scroll modifier. And inside this vertical scroll function, we need to pass scroll state. So I will pass a default option that is remember scroll state. So I will pass this scroll state and inside the column, I can display user card. Let's say I will display user card. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, or I can simply run a loop here. Let's say for I in 1 to 10. And 10 times I will display user card like this. Now, instead of setting this user card to my content, I will set user list like this. And if I run the application now, I will see the list of user cards. Let's see it. So here you can see we are getting a list of user cards, but we want to build a recycler view. And the benefit of recycler view is we will only compose the layouts that is currently visible in the viewport. But with this approach, when we run the application, all the user cards are composed in the layout. But to make it like recycler view, we want only the visible cards should be composed in our layout. And to do this, instead of this column, we need to use lazy column. So let's see how we can do it. So instead of this column, I hope you have written this code. So I will comment it out for now. You can download the source code. The link will be given in the description of this video. So what I will do is I will use lazy column this time. Now this function will compose only the visible items in the viewport. So I will use this function that is lazy column. And in the trailing lambda, we have some functions to add items to my lazy column. So what I will do is I will use items function. So we have this items function. Make sure your items function should accept a list as a first parameter. So if you want to add multiple items to your list, you can use items. And when we build a recycler view, we have a model class that we pass to our adapter, recycler view adapter. And in this case, instead of building an adapter, you will use this items function. Or if you want to add only a single item, then you have this item function. So you have this item function that you will use to add a single item. But for now, I want to add multiple items and I will use this items function. And inside this function, I will pass list of users. So far, we have built a user card that is static and we are not passing anything dynamic to this function. But you can create your model class and you can pass the instance here to this user card composable function. And you can use attributes of this instance to display information about user. But for now, I will use the static information only, so I will not pass anything dynamic. Because I have to pass some items to this items function, what I will do is I will create a list. So what I can do is I can simply create a list. Let's say I want list of numbers from 1 to 10 like this, and I can convert it as list using the toList function. So we have items and we have 10 items, 10 integers inside this items function. In real cases, you will pass actual list to this items function. For now, I just passed a list of integers. And in real scenarios, you might have a data class like this. Let's say we have a data class user, and inside this class, you will have some properties. Let's say for now, I have ID. I will pass only one property to this user class. And what I can do now is I can create a list of users like this, or I will create this list here only. Let's say I have users and it is list of user. And let's say ID is 1 and I have, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 items. And now instead of this 1 to 10, what I can do is I can pass users. And I do not need this toList function here. So we have users, and inside the trailing lambda, I will get individual user. And this user I can pass to my composable function to display the actual information to the layout. So what I will do now is I will simply call the user card function, because currently our card is static and we are not displaying anything dynamic. So this is my lazy column. We used this function items. We passed the list that contains our items that we want to display in our list. And inside the trailing lambda, we get individual items and we call our composable function. That is basically the list item. In this case, this is my list item. So it will display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 user cards here. So if I run this application now, I should get list of cards. So let's run it. And if you want to preview your composable function, then instead of passing this user card here, you can pass user list like this. And let's build and refresh. And here you can see we have a list of user cards. And if I run the application, I will get the same output. The only difference is this time it is lazy column and only the items that are visible in the current viewport are composed. And when you scroll down, the items that are visible are composed in our layout. So this is how the lazy column works, and you can use it to create a recycler view in your Jetpack Compose project. And you can also see how easy it is. We just created a lazy column and we passed all the list items using this items function. And we are calling our composable function for our item, that is user card. So this is how easily we can build a list using Jetpack Compose. Now compare it with your recycler view and compare the difference in lines of code. It is awesome, right? So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. In case you have any problem, confusion or question, you can leave it in the comments below. And please help me to reach 100,000 subscribers as soon as possible, because we are at 99.3k subscribers and I need around 700 subscribers only to touch that mark. So please share this video with all your friends and help me reach that point very quickly. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.